For the last 40 years, the Cincinnati Zoo has been world-renowned for our cat ambassador program. It all started with a cheetah named Angel and has continued ever since. And daily there are runs right up here in our running yard that are a lot of fun at our cheetah encounter. I'm here with Linda Castaneda, who runs the program, and Tommy T, everybody's favorite cheetah. He is a big boy, 115 pounds?
Yep.
Man alive. Now that's big for a cheetah, right?
It is pretty big for a cheetah. He's tall.
Yeah.
So that's where we get that weight from. He is a male, and that's pretty average for a male. It's probably the top of the male scale.
Now, I can hear him purring from here. What's that mean?
It just means he's content.
Okay.
So cheetahs will purr. They're technically a small cat.
Okay.
Despite his size, because they can purr. Cats can either purr or roar. So his purring just means that he's happy. He loves hanging out with people, and he's getting some scratches, being groomed. And he's a pretty good-sized purr, too.
Now, I know this program's had more than a dozen cheetahs over the many years, but obviously a wild cheetah wouldn't sit here and purr and have you pet him. So how does all that work? How do you do that?
How does that happen? Well, Tom was our first ambassador born out at our mast farm.
Oh, okay, yeah.
So we've had many cheetahs born out there over the years, but he was the first one that came to us in the ambassador program. And so when a mom can't raise the cheetahs, we do take them and raise them in human care, and that's when they make great ambassadors. So he's been doing this since he was 6 days old, and he learns that people are friends, and he learns to trust his animal care team that we're only going to put him in good situations, and so he can hang out in close proximity to us.
And Tommy T is a great name because it's named after Tom Tenenfeld, who runs our mast farm, so that's pretty cool. And you know the other thing, Linda, Tommy may be the most famous cheetah in the world. If you think about it, he had his own fold-out in National Geographic magazine.
He did. He is a centerfold. So the November 2012 issue of National Geographic has Cuba on the cover, but also Tommy T. And if you look inside, there's this amazing centerfold photo of him running. We did this great collaboration with National Geographic where we had them filming our cats running in high speed, slow motion out at our mast farm. So it's our breeding farm, but we also have a great space out there to run our cheetahs. And a lot of great photos and great video came from that run. So Tom was the best runner of the week and is our local celebrity for...
Well, I remember that story and, of course, the photos and how elaborate it is when National Geographic shows up. They don't just shoot it once, they shoot all week. Is he the one in the video as well?
He is the one in the video. If you look, the original famous Nat Geo video, that's him, absolutely. Which is kind of fun. It's full circle because he was born out at that mast farm.
Oh, my gosh.
And his dad is one of the cheetahs originally gifted from Namibia as well. So it's kind of fun.
He has wild genes.
Seen that poster at Cheetah Conservation Fund in Namibia. So it's a really cool full circle moment for cheetahs and the effort that everybody puts in collaboratively globally in order to save the species.
I see his big claws. They say they're built like dogs, I guess. His legs look a lot like dogs. Those must help him run.
They are. They do help him run. So they are more dog-like. We kind of compare them to a greyhound. And everything on him is an adaptation for running. So we have very large eyes to see 3 miles because we're a sight hunter. Spots help us to camouflage and get close as we can to our prey. And then those big feet do help us out. They're kind of like cleats or track shoes. He says, I'm going to use them right now and try to run away, you guys. So everything on his body is really built to be the fastest animal on land. And then we sacrifice a little bit. So we obviously don't have good nails for climbing.
Right.
When we have nails for running. And then you can see his long tail. It's in perfect position right now. It's not fluffy and round like most cats use for balance while they're climbing. It's instead used for balance when they're running. So they can make quick turns and use it as a counterbalance and not fall when they're chasing after dinner.
Now, the purpose of the program, of course, is these guys are ambassadors telling the story. That's what the zoo's in, the animal storytelling business. How are cheetahs doing in nature?
Cheetahs are doing okay. We'd like to see them doing a lot better, but the good news is that we know what the issues are with cheetahs, and that's the conflict with people, and then we can support organizations that help people and wildlife like cheetahs live together. So while we're saying the numbers aren't as great as we'd like them to be, we're actively participating in making sure that number goes up.
And I know in some areas they've stabilized, and in national parks it's relatively common to see them, but wildlife everywhere is under a lot of pressure. But by working together, folks can do it. And I just say this, the next time you come to the zoo, be sure to come to the Cheetah Encounter. It doesn't just run in the summer. How late in the year does it run?
We go all the way to October 31st.
Come on.
Yeah.
This is a hard-working cat. All right, Linda, thanks. Tommy T, that's quite a cat.